Hello. Welcome to hell. Also, I'm going to play some more Doom. This is the shores of hell, so we are not quite in hell yet. We are well on our way. This episode might be a little bit longer, or I might have to split it into two. This is longer and more difficult than episode one. I might die a time or two. Kind of depends on how lucky I get with finding the arrow and how much it makes me do to track down the Keymaster. It's a good idea to agitate these enemies so they start infighting, because this teleporter back here will take you to their location. And they'll probably start, yeah, making their way to me. So you can pick them off one at a time, ideally, if they don't keep teleporting back. Wow, a shotgun guy made it all the way to the teleporter. I wonder how they know they have to teleport to find me. I don't know. One thing I'm not too sure about with this game is how exactly the AI works. It's not something that I understand in general. AI is pretty difficult. A lot of algorithms involved. I don't know how pathfinding works, but sometimes this game can surprise me with how sophisticated the AI is. One thing that I did learn after messing around with modding and looking at textures and everything, different objects you can place in the world, the corners of this triangle here, they always read as spikes to me. Like, they look like metal spikes with like the light kind of glinting off of the top of them, but they're candles, which I guess makes sense. They don't hurt you when you touch them, as you would expect spikes to do. I always wondered what the point of them was, but they're just a little decorative candle thing. Alright, let's hit that, and then that will open up a secret back here, which I don't know if I want to do this yet or wait until I have better weapons. I mean, going this way will get me. Wait. Right, that just takes me back here, and then the secret is back here. So there's the Keymaster. I think I'll, I might use my let them teleport to me strategy here, or try to. Seems like a more sensible way to handle this. Of course, if the Keymaster teleports out, then I'm probably going to have to retreat. Yeah. So where does that teleporter actually lead? Wait, oh shoot. Okay. I didn't think he would find me. Once again, I underestimate the AI. Okay. Well, I'll come back to you. Let's go back here, grab this health and armor. Oh, there's the arrow. That's convenient. See if I can pick off these demons from down here before I bring them down to my level. You know, I don't play fair. The Doomslayer doesn't play fair. But that's okay, because there's 50 billion of them and one of me. So I'm just using every advantage I have to level the playing field a little bit. Alright, after I grab this health and then immediately lose it. Okay, that's probably good. I will go back for the key now. It should make this level a good bit easier. Having the key early on. There we go. Alright, is there anything... Yeah, there's this. Whole reason I came in here in the first place. The plasma rifle. Or plasma... What's it called? Plasma gun, I guess, is the official term. I don't know. I think I remember seeing it referred to as a plasma rifle in some context. Anyway, that's what I always called it, even though it's not really a rifle. Maybe one of those childhood fancies. Alright, this level actually isn't too much longer. Sort of a short little... Well, other than the secret cockademon, this would be the first cockademon you see in the game. The first and second cockademon. And that is about it. Pretty small level. Like I said, easy into things. I'm going to try to be a little bit more fastidious about exploring these levels and getting things, because when I'm playing in this mode, I have a tendency to kind of want to rush it, like I'm speedrunning, and I'm not really speedrunning. Oh, there's the Keymaster. That sucks. I can see the appeal in speedrunning this mode if you did not have the randomization turned on and you had the the same placement of the arrow and the Keymaster. It would be fun to do like a speedrun race with someone. But I'm going to take my time, which is another reason this might be a longer video, or I might have to split it into two videos. Because if I'm not careful about exploring the level, I might not have the resources I need in later levels. Like, it might be really easy to get through some of these early levels just because of lucky placement of the arrow, and then I end up not exploring and not getting all the weapons, and I am in trouble later on when the levels aren't so easy. But I'm still going to stick to my no quick saving policy, at least for now. Which means I might end up having to redo some stuff, because it is quite possible that I will die. You know, traditionally I play these games save scumming the hell out of them. You know, I press F6 or whatever the quick save key is. You know, every time I encounter a group of enemies. Or after every group of enemies I slay. And that's not the most entertaining thing to watch, I think. Just beating my head against a segment over and over again. Also, if you quick save, you're not always in the best position, and you might try to, you know, it's very easy to quick save when you have 10 health and you're trying to get through an area, and because you have 10 health you just keep failing over and over again. And sometimes in those situations it's better to just restart the level and try to beat the whole thing again with full health. Later on, especially in Doom 2, the levels just get gigantic, so playing them without quick saving is not going to be practical. By the way, this thing, we haven't seen this yet, this is a Berserk pack. If I pick this up, it will increase the amount of damage I do with my fist, which I'm, you know, neutral on. I rarely take advantage of that feature. More importantly, it will restore your health to 100 no matter what it is. So I will leave that there, come back for it in case I need it. So, if you have 2 health, I mean, if you have more than 100 health, of course, it's not going to drop you to 100, but, you know, you can pick that thing up with 1 health, and it'll take you back up to full instantly, which is a pretty nice feature. I'm out of shotgun ammo? Do I have my... No, I don't have a chain gun yet, but I'm about to. Which is good. Also, I turned off auto weapon switching, which is an annoying feature, mostly, because, well, you only automatically switch to a weapon that you pick up if you don't already have it, so after the first couple levels, it's really not a big deal, but there's always a chance that you will pick up a rocket launcher for the first time, or I will. It'll auto-switch, and I will blow myself up accidentally. So, I would much rather switch to the weapon manually. Plus, you know, who's to say I'm even necessarily going to want to use that weapon? So, much rather take care of that myself. Oh, I can't go this way yet. Oh, that was a mistake. Okay. I forget what I have to do. I think there's a way to, like, raise a platform that'll get you out of the acid. After the fiasco in the last episode, with the secret right next to the entrance, I want to be a little bit more thorough about checking suspicious looking walls or testing to see if something is some sort of switch. Let's see. I guess I'll go this way. I am running low on ammunition, but luckily there's some around the corner here, I think there's some shotgun shells in these weird little, I don't know what these are supposed to be, weird elevator devices. I don't know what type of machinery this is supposed to be. Where am I? Containment area. So we're no longer on Phobos, which is where episode 1 takes place. We are now on Deimos, which I think is another moon of Mars. And of course, the boundary between our reality and Hell is starting to grow thinner. I'm going to get this key card, even though, you know, I don't need it. I already have the yellow key card, just in case that triggers anything else to open. In general, I think I should try to play these levels basically the way you would play in order. Even though I have all the keys and I don't necessarily need to go in order, it's a good idea just because it encourages me to explore everything and just be thorough. Oh, hey. Yet another plasma launcher. Plasma gun. Oh. Okay. So that's all that switch does. So yeah, we are at the shores of Hell. Oh, hello. Excellent. So let's go ahead and make our way back to the beginning, which is where we know the Keymaster is. This is a weird puzzle, by the way. You have to, like, almost step into the lava, but not quite, to make these platforms raise. It's kind of cool. I dig it. See, this is a situation where if I was taking advantage of my jump key here, which you're not supposed to have, you can just run and just grab the yellow key without worrying about that. So that's an instance where cheating is possible. Also, there was a little nook here I should probably explore. Yeah, all kinds of goodies here. All right, so I want to go north, right? Yeah, it's gonna be around here somewhere. I think. Unless he wandered. Oh. Hello. Alright, buddy. Where are you? Oh yeah, this track has some... It sounds like a little bit of digital distortion. Like the little clicks. Click noises. That's what it sounds like. Not distortion, but corruption. Like that's what it sounds like when an MP3 gets corrupted. Here and there. And I'm not sure if it's supposed to sound like that or not. Or if it sounds like that in the original track. I'm gonna have to compare and see if the track got corrupted somehow when I made the WAD. There's not much of it, which is why I don't think it's intentional. It wouldn't exist just for those few seconds. Oh! If you don't grab that backpack. Well, yeah, you can get it later. So this part is kind of weird. There are these three switches here which correspond to these three doors out here. And if I actually approach, like if I go into this room, these switches will retract. So I think what I want to do is open all of the doors first. You know, take care of any enemies that appear. And that way I can get the contents of all three rooms. Which is good, because I definitely want that rocket launcher and these rockets. I've had runs in this episode where I don't get the rocket launcher until like level 4 or 5 or something. And that's not fun. Alright, I still need the... Oh wait, no, I have the key. Never mind. There's more of that popping. Yeah, I'm gonna have to check the original MP3 and fix the WAD if I got a bad version of it or something. It might be intentional though. It's hard to tell with Bull of Heaven. They are a very noisy band, which I enjoy. I know not everyone does. I'm into some artful noise. So these crushers, if you know the way crushers work in Doom, they don't seem that dangerous. Because you only take damage like while you're being crushed, which is the way crushing works in real life too. But what I mean is, like if those crushers maintained that speed while you were being crushed, you would just take a little bit of damage and be fine. But some of them, once you start being crushed, the speed of them slows down and you just slowly get crushed to death. I don't remember if that's how these work or not, but I don't want to take any chances. Also, your hitbox in Doom is bigger than you might think. So it's very easy to get, you know, not pixel, but I guess it's kind of being pixeled, even though your form in this game is not made of pixels. I guess there's no actual way to get up here by going through the acid. Interesting. All right, let's conserve my my plasma ammo there. Alright, I don't think there's anything else I need to do on this level. No point in going back for the Berserk pack because it doesn't carry over to the next level. 13 minutes. Damn. Didn't seem like that long. Also, I don't know why the starting door in this level is the exit door texture. It's kind of weird. Alright, I want to go in here first before I deal with the cacodemons. Alright, we have another Berserk pack there, which I might get in a second. Yeah, tear him up, Kako. Show him who's boss. Who's king of the monsters? You are. Zombie guy. What even is that? It's not a zombie. It's a gun. Zombies can't shoot guns. Well. I guess the idea of zombies shooting guns has become more acceptable recently. If Fallout 76 has anything to say about it. You know, the authority on video games, Fallout 76. Yeah, tear him up. Ah. If monsters are infighting, there is a chance that they will see you and become distracted from their target and come after you instead. Or just get distracted and kind of wander off. I think that happens sometimes too. Hey! I'll deal with you later. I mean, you don't have to deal with them at all. They're in Cacodemon jail. Man, double damage rocket launcher didn't kill them? Cacodemons are tough. Wonder if there are any secrets inside Cacodemon jail. I don't think so. It's just kind of there to intimidate you. Oh, hello. Hey, I'm invisible. Easy, Keymaster. Please. Couldn't master your way out of a paper bag. More invisibility items in this game than I remember. I think there wasn't a thing in the 32X version, which, as I've mentioned, was the first way I played this game. The 32X version was missing kind of a lot. It was missing the entire third episode, which means no Cyber Demon. I think it was missing the invisibility sphere. I mean, it was missing the specters, the invisible demon things, because I guess the 32X couldn't handle the transparency effect. So it would make sense that you couldn't be invisible either, because it couldn't render your weapon as transparent or translucent. People have come to refer to these monsters as pinky demons, which, as far as I'm concerned, that's a total retronym. I never heard anyone call them pinky demons before, like, the 2010s. Like, in the manual and in the end screen, they're always just referred to as demons. Oh, hi. I thought there was something else back here. Nice. And I know you're going to say, well, aren't they all demons? They come from hell. And yeah, but you know, there are different taxonomies. You know, imps are, you know, all imps are demons, but not all demons are imps, you know. These are kind of the generic, you know, what people call the pinkies. They're kind of the generic demon, you know, the all-purpose demon. Oh, hi. I always thought that was a little weird how it says a secret is revealed, like, in the passive voice. I don't know. Most of the messages in this game are active voice. You know, you found the shotgun, you got, you know, whatever. You got the Berserk pack. Or actually, I think that message is just Berserk. The bad thing about the auto map is sometimes it's hard to tell what is something that you can pass. So the brown lines indicate a difference in floor height, basically. So like here, there's a brown line on the map because you step down onto a different floor, and sometimes something could, you know, like this. It's you can't tell from the map if this is a way you can actually go or not, which is a little frustrating. Usually when you see two brown lines close together, that means it's a window and you can't actually go that way, but that's not always the case. And there's no way to differentiate the two on the auto map, which is a little frustrating. Starting to see meat elevators now. They still sound like regular elevators. There must be some mechanics going on underneath the meat. Or that's just what meat sounds like. Well, that is about it. Except for this room. Or this direction, rather. Oh, mega armor. I guess most of the messages, like, the verb is active. You know, picked up. Picked up picked up the object, but there's no subject. Like, it doesn't say you picked up the mega armor. It just says picked up the mega armor. But still, it doesn't say the mega armor was picked up, which, I don't know, just always struck me as a little weird, the secret message. Or not the secret message, the message it gives you when you find a secret. I think there's a Baron of Hell around here somewhere. I may be getting this confused with another level, though. I'm not sure what the deal with this thing is. Looks like there should be something here. I didn't pick anything up here, did I? Wait. Looks like that should hold some sort of significant object. I don't remember if I got one there or not. Okay, where's the exit? It is... Oh, right. I didn't actually go into the exit room, so it's not going to show on the map. I think it's... Oh, yeah. That's right. It's, like, right next to the entrance. Just, you have to circle around a little bit. Nope. Through here, I guess. Yeah, let's take the long way. It's not going to take that long to get there, since we're running at 90 miles per hour. Backtracking in Doom isn't so bad once all the enemies are dead. because he moves so fast. Hey, 100% kills. Nice. Deimos Lab. I want to say there is a secret somewhere in the starting area. Oh, yeah. No, it's not Macho 1. Oh, I guess that's not going to close again, but the texture on this wall was slightly different. Like, there was some moss on it. Helps to pay attention to that stuff, which I am traditionally not very good at. Yeah, this is map 4. This is where things start to get kind of tough. So this place is weird. The way you get in here into this cage area is by just standing beside this pedestal here. I'm gonna get my rocket launcher ready because I know what's coming up. Lost souls. The most annoying enemy in Doom. Everyone agrees. They are absurdly fast, and they take way too many hits to kill. They take like 3 shotgun blasts. They are as strong as demons, approximately, if not exactly. And they're just obnoxious flying skulls. And, you know, if you're using a rocket launcher, they love flying directly into the barrel of your rocket launcher, causing you to explode yourself. What? That's weird. This door must have been open, and there must be a trigger line somewhere. It must be this, the thing that's showing up as the green line here. Walking over that must have triggered this door to close. Because the way you open it again is by shooting it, which is an example of that feature that I forgot about in the last episode. Shooting something to activate it. Fighting cockademons and barons of hell while you're invisible can be a little tricky, because they don't get a good bead on you, and their shots often go wide, but instinctively you want to, you know, dodge to the left or right, and sometimes, because their aim is so bad, you can slip up and dodge right into the path of their shot. So invisibility, not all it's cracked up to be. It's super useful against the hitscan enemies, though. Well, in this game, just the zombie men and the shotgun guys. Oh, there's a Keymaster. Golly. Golly gee. But yeah, the zombie man and the shotgun guy. They are hitscan enemies, meaning their projectiles don't actually exist. They just... the term comes from the way they... Basically, imagine an invisible line shooting out in front of the enemy in whatever direction it's looking, scanning for targets, and if a target is in the path of that invisible line, you know, it gets hit. Hit scan. Oh. I have plenty of shotgun ammo. Not gonna rush this. Take my time. Nice. But in Doom 2, there are much worse hitscan enemies, the chain gunner and this... Actually, I guess the Spider Mastermind is in Doom 1, technically. It's the boss of Episode 3, but you encounter many more of them in Doom 2. And they are a bad time. And when I was a kid, it wasn't really intuitive to me that hitscan weapons were that much deadlier. Like, my thought process was, okay, these crushers will definitely slow down if you step under them, so be careful. My thought process was, well, the rocket launcher is better than the chain gun, of course, so an enemy shooting me with a chain gun is going to be less scary than an enemy shooting me with a rocket launcher, which turns out isn't the case. Turns out I am a lot better at dodging rockets than the enemies are, and the enemies are a lot better at aiming the chain gun than I am. So it is a real give and take kind of situation. So I got the computer map, which draws the rest of the level map in this light gray line, so we can see where all the secret areas are. I don't know how I get into this one here in the lower right, but fortunately we don't have to. I mean, there might be some good stuff in there, but I have every weapon except the BFG, so I'm not too worried about it. I'll get a BFG eventually, I think. Actually, you might not, or I might not, unless I know which secret, you know, how to get to the secrets, the secret area that contains the BFG, but getting the BFG isn't that important. Alright, so I want to go this way. Wow, it's giving me a lot of invincibility, or invisibility. Wait, I forgot how much of a thing that was. Hey, I'll take that. Well, I'll take these, even though I don't need them. I'm at 200 health. The most health. I'm the healthiest as it is possible to be. And my armor is only slightly scuffed. Okay. Yeah, let's go this way. And then this way, and then north. And by north, I mean whichever direction that is. I mean, you know, we're not on Earth. We don't have magnetic poles. Well, I guess a moon of Mars would still have magnetic poles. They would just be much weaker. But, you know, concepts of north and south are not necessarily applicable when you're not on Earth. Oh, right. Alright, grab this stuff. These doors will open. Having weapons that do double or quadruple damage really eliminates a lot of the tedium from a lot of these encounters. Because, like, if it's just you with a shotgun facing down a cockademon, that's not a difficult thing. Like, the cockademon's projectiles are slow and they are easily dodgeable. You know, there's no real challenge there. Sidestepping the cockademon shots and you know, shooting it to death, hitting it 8 times with a standard shotgun, you know, 8 or 9 times. You know, that's just time consuming. It's just bullet spongery. So I appreciate taking a little bit of the tedium out of it. So there are a couple ways you can approach this section coming up. I like dropping down here. It is a little scary because as soon as you teleport here, you're looking right at a cockademon's butt, which is not a pleasant thing to look at. Don't ask about those holes, but it gives you a plasma gun right before that, so you can make short work of it. All right, I want to raise these staircases as I descend, because if I don't, I'm going to back into this hallway, not be able to go back up, and have a bad time. So I sort of took the stealthy back entrance here instead of going right into the heart of this chamber, which will, you know, it alerts the enemies, so they are out and about, but it also gives you a lot of leeway for dealing with them. Not a big fan of the plasma gun sound effect. The plasma gun and the chainsaw, two weapons that I don't get a lot of enjoyment out of using them because of how they sound. Now the shotgun, classic sound effect, one of the all-time greats. The chain gun, it's okay. It's not my favorite, but it doesn't grate on me. So yeah, we dropped down there and took the teleporter instead of taking the elevator. We took the elevator then. I think there are, I don't know, there might be Barons of Hell just roaming around this area if you go that way. Alright, so now we take this teleporter. And then you have a big old lava pool here. So you want to drop down, hit the switch, teleport back again. So hitting that switch raises the platform to the exit, but before you go to the exit, you want to wait for this platform to raise so you can grab that soul sphere. A secret is revealed. I don't know if anyone watching is a fan of the band Bright Eyes, but whenever I see a secret is revealed, it always reminds me of the song The Calendar Hung Itself, the part where Connor Oberst says, "A secret is revealed." I don't actually know how to pronounce Connor Oberst's last name. I've never had to say it out loud before. So, apologies if that is incorrect. You don't need to kill those demons. You know, they're no threat to me up there, but I'm going to have to deal with them eventually. And especially with that Keymaster running around, it's going to make my life hard. I'm a little curious as to how the Keymaster's invincibility works, because I feel like you might be able to damage them before you get the arrow, but you can't actually kill them. Like, I think I can get it down to basically one hit point. And then once I get the arrow... this thing is fast, by the way. Turns out, demons are already pretty fast. And when they have the power of the Keymaster, they are a force to be reckoned with. Alright, I got the demon back up in his little chamber there, so hopefully it doesn't come after me. It's too confused. Hey! Good to see you too. It's not a secret. I stood here and a thing opened. I didn't cause that to happen. Oh boy. Okay. Alright. Let's, be cool, Duke. You're fine. Alright. Let us dispatch the Keymaster. I wouldn't trust a demon with the key, to be honest. How do I get... Oh, right. Okay. I don't know, it's hard to tell if that demon, if it was already hurt or not. Like, it seemed like it should have taken more damage from a chain gun than that. If it is, you know, if it does have three times, effectively three times the health of a normal demon. This is one of my favorite Bull of Heaven tracks, by the way. It's called 80,000 Species of Mischievous Sprites. It's one of the most recommended tracks for someone who's not familiar with them to check them out. It's about 30 minutes long, which is short by Bull of Heaven standards. And it starts out with a very slow, kind of drony introduction. Very slow build-up. The drums slowly start coming in, you know. Subtle at first, and then it gradually gets less subtle. And it becomes sort of cacophonous, which is always fun. I like a slow build-up to cacophony. Wow, I'm already at 45 minutes. I'm only on map 5. Dang. Doesn't seem like it's been that long. Well, time flies when you're facing down the forces of hell. I've gotten pretty lucky with arrow placement and Keymaster locations so far. I haven't really had to go hunting for anything. I haven't been frustrated by not knowing how to get something. Which, really, that's on me for turning off the radar ping. Like, in the previous episode, when I was looking all over the level and it was the secret right beside the entrance there. If I had the radar ping on, I would have known how close I was to it, and it would have caused me to start searching that area before I did. So, you know, I can't blame anyone but myself for that. But I don't like the radar ping sound, and I don't know. I mean, it wasn't like a nightmare. It wasn't like, it was a little frustrating, but it wasn't, you know, I wasn't really angry. I might have played it up a little bit for the microphone, which I do sometimes just for a dramatic effect. You know, it was more of a, oh, you bastard kind of reaction. It was like sort of you know, respectful acknowledgement of a foe. Dang. There is a whole other wing of the command center that I don't have to do because I have everything. I am running a little bit low on ammo other than shotgun ammo, but I mean, the shotgun's all you really need. Aw, that means I'm going to have to exit the level before the music gets good. Okay, well, I can't have that, so I'll waste a little bit more time here. I do this in real life, too. If I'm listening to some music and I'm not on a strict, you know, deadline, I don't have to be somewhere at like a specific time, I will let the music play out before doing whatever I was planning to do. If it's music I like. Which I try not to listen to music I don't like, as a general rule. But, you know, sometimes you're listening to internet radio or a podcast, and it's not always my favorite. I don't know why I chose this track for this level specifically. I just had a couple of slower ambient tracks for the previous levels, and I just needed a stronger, faster one. Although it doesn't start out fast, it gets there. It picks up. I'm concerned about this. There are, every now and then, there is an acid pit that you can't get back out of. Okay. Oh, so there's an actual thing down there. Alright. Alright, I don't know how I actually get to the plasma gun, but can I just, like, there's no way I can jump this gap, right? Or skim across this gap? No. Okay, so I'll grab that. And there must be some way out of here, because otherwise they wouldn't have put that ammo there. If this is a death trap, oh, here we go. Yeah, I was going to say, if that was a death trap, I was cheating my way out of that, because that is bullshit. I mean, I'm not a fan of acid death traps in Doom in general, or acid in general. The way I usually deal with it is just save scumming, but since I'm trying not to do that, I have to be a little bit more cautious. But even when I'm safe scumming, it's still annoying. Like, okay, you got me. I can't go in this acid. Probably my least favorite design element in Doom. And that happens a lot in, like, Final Doom. God, those levels can get so obnoxious with the... And Doom 2... to a lesser extent. Well, I guess Doom 2 does it a lot too. Just huge expanses of acid, and you just have to tank the damage to figure out where to go. So when I eventually get to Doom 2, I will either play on Hurt Me Plenty, or I will save scum, or allow myself more saves at least. There's a pretty good mod called Auto-Autosave, which basically allows you to script your own checkpoints, sort of. Well, not script, but you can configure it to have checkpoints. But okay. Weird ceiling lava trap. Don't know what the deal with that is. But anyway, you can configure it to autosave on certain events, so you can have it autosave whenever you pick up a key, or whenever your health is at a certain level, or you can just have it autosave, you know, every few minutes. So if I do end up using saves, which, I mean, it's almost a guarantee for Doom 2, because those levels are just gigantic, so when that eventually happens, I will figure out some way to configure auto-autosave to make it fair and yet not don't want to make it too easy on myself, which you can absolutely do, you know, which I have done in the past, just hammering that F6 button. The music is still building up. God. So yeah, a lot of people aren't into music with like a 12-minute build-up. That might be a little excessive for some people. But, you know, I listen to like post-rock, and some jam band music. I'm very particular about jam bands. I'm not a deadhead. That's not my kind of thing. I mean, I've enjoyed Grateful Dead music in the past, but uh I'm more into the instrumental aspect of it than the lyrical vocal aspect of it. But songs with a 12-minute build-up, you know, I like the tension and the release. You know, I like trance music too. It's just it's a formula that works for me. I mean, I might as well try to get every secret while I'm waiting for the music to get there. I'm not going to listen to the whole track. There we go. So yeah, the drummer just goes nuts. Oh. Oh, if I didn't already have a chainsaw, then that would be much appreciated. So the one, like this one and this one up here, you must teleport into them from somewhere. I don't know where. And then this one, that looks like it's just a door I didn't open. So I'll get the one in the middle. Well, there we go. Oh, okay. There's more to it. I kind of thought this door would just open out into a chamber I've already been in. Okay. Where's the exit? It is right here. You can tell because there's a green line. That doesn't automatically mean it's an exit. It could just be a general switch, but since this is sort of a self-contained room, that usually means that's the exit. I can't make these videos too long because I'm putting the full quality archive, well, the full quality video on archive.org as an alternative that you can download. Even though their speeds have not been very conducive to that recently, which, you know, that's fine. I mean, they're giving me gigabytes of storage and bandwidth for free, so I can't complain too much about the speed, but it's an alternative for people who want it, because YouTube, it turns out, bit crushes the hell out of my videos. Oh. Well, how do you do? I don't like this situation. Oh. Oh, this must go to one of the secret levels. I don't want to do that. But yeah, the full quality video for the first episode was 4.8 gigs, and it was only an hour and 15 minutes, so I'd like to keep it under 5 gigs. I'm not 100% sure I'm even allowed to upload files larger than 5 gigs. I mean, I can always recompress it a little bit, but that would take a lot of time, you know, use a lower bitrate. I'm recording at the recommended, you know, in the OBS recording settings, there are basically three recommended levels. There's lossless, which gives you just absurdly gigantic files, which are for, you know, professionals, people who actually make videos for a living, who need the full quality archive for their own purposes. There's also high, which gives you it says high quality large file size, and then I'm the one below that. Oh, okay, I can get this plasma gun now. I'm not sure which event actually triggered this bridge to extend, but I'll grab that. But yeah, I'm using good quality medium file size. And that still gives me a 4.8 gigabyte file. And to me, the video is mostly indistinguishable. First-person games are tricky to record. I mean, they're not tricky to record. They're tricky to make look good. Especially really fast first-person games. Like, I understand if people can't watch these videos at all because of, like, motion sickness issues. I know that's a problem for some people, and some people can't even play games like this. And for some people, it's worse when they try to watch someone else play. Like, it's worse for their motion sickness than if they were doing it themselves. So, apologies to anyone who experiences that sort of thing. Hopefully, you can at least, you know, listen to the video in the background if that's something that you like to do. I mean, it's something that I like to do. I often listen to videos while I do other stuff instead of actually watching them. But for me, having the full quality 60 frames per second video, it makes it more watchable. Like, I don't get motion sick per se, at least not from that. But it's easier for me to watch the full, you know, it looks basically exactly like it looks when I play, so that's easier for me. For some people, the smoothness of the video might be something that triggers their motion sickness. Oh boy. In which case, you can, if you drop the YouTube video down to, you know, 480p or whatever, then you can watch the 30 frame per second version instead, and that might be more watchable for you. But, you know, for me, the high quality, smooth 60fps video is easier to watch, so I like to make the full quality version available. Of course, the 1080p 60 version is on YouTube. It's just bit crushed and not quite as flawless a video. So normally I would save this Berserk pack for when I actually need it, but on this level in particular, you need to grab the Berserk pack before this section opens. Which is really, this part is just mean. I mean, they give you enough health packs to deal with it, but I don't like being forced to go through acid. Just in general, it's not a good time. So here's the exit. Normally, we wouldn't see this for a very long time because you need all three key cards to open this. I haven't really even looked at my compass yet. Oh yeah. This track has some weird backward speech. Which, you know, I think that's cool and appropriate to the material, you know. Oh, hi, Baron of Hell. The classic trope of demonic speech or satanic speech being masked in heavy metal music backwards. I mean, not that this is heavy metal, but it still sounds pretty satanic, so I think it's appropriate. I know it can creep some people out, so sorry if you're not into it. Actually, I can't tell if it's backwards or if it's just very heavily distorted. Alright, I'll come back here. Since the arrow, so this section with the, there's like a warning sign there You can open that up. Let me get back there real quick. Oh, hello. I'm into satanic media. I think Satan gets a bad rap sometimes. Right, so this. I guess that's just a no human sign. That's a warning sign you don't want to see if you're a human, which I am. So, yeah, this is like a whole other section of this compound, the Halls of the Damned. I don't know what the purpose of this building is, but when you go into that section, there's a lot of bad stuff in there. And hopefully I won't have to, since it looks like neither the arrow nor the Keymaster are in there. Oh, you know what? I bet it's, yeah, I bet that hallway is going to circle around. Because I don't think there is a path in this section. So yeah, looks like I am going to have to go that way after all. Damn it. Oh well. I saw someone streaming some Doom games who, every time he started a new level, he would... So he wasn't playing in GZ Doom, he was playing the official port, and in the menu here there's a restart level option, and every time he started a new level, he would immediately restart it, so you would spawn in with, you know, no weapons and 100 health. Well, you would have the pistol, which they call that a pistol start, and he was saying that that's like secretly the way the levels are designed to be played. Like, you're supposed to start with a pistol every time. Hold that thought. Let me take care of some business here. Okay. And I don't know where he's getting that. Like, I've never heard that as a thing. Like they designed the levels so that you can play them if all you have is a pistol. Because they don't know what resources you're going to have going in. So like the reason they put that chainsaw there, the one in the secret I just found, you know, it's not because they're expecting me to restart this level and only have a pistol. It's in case I didn't find the previous chainsaws, because, you know, that's not a guarantee. Oh god. Oh no, 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 I forgot about this. Ugh. I mean, I didn't forget about this, but I thought it was in another section. I hate this. Like, why would they do that? They throw a bunch of enemies at you, and of course your instinct is to back up, you know, get away from them. And then you get crushed to death. Like, that's just punitive. That's like, that wasn't a fun challenge that I have to overcome. That's just, you know, I want to be the guy arbitrary bullshit. Also, I guess the Keymaster wasn't re-randomized, which is weird. Or it was re-randomized and it just happened to roll the same enemy. But yeah, they design all the levels so that just in case you're going into them, having not found, you know, whatever, having not picked up whatever weapons and health and stuff was available, like, they give you stuff. But, like, they don't expect you to play that way. Like, otherwise, they wouldn't put anything next to an exit. Like, you always see situations where... there's, you know, a soul sphere next, you know, right before an exit or something, or like a bunch of rockets right before an exit. Like, they clearly expect you to carry that stuff into the next level. Like, they design all the levels so that they can be finished with a pistol, you know, from a pistol start in theory, but I don't think anyone expects you to do that, unless you're doing, like, Ultra Violence, you know, single-level speedruns, which is a thing. You know, load into a level in Ultra Violence, try to speedrun it. You know, traditionally, you would do that from just a pistol start. But that's, like, a very special situation. And the idea that, like, you're somehow depriving yourself if you don't do a pistol start, it seems really silly to me. Like, really unnecessary kind of showing off. And this wasn't, like, some Doom expert who was, like, skillfully playing all the levels. Like, he was dying a lot and having a really bad time because he didn't have any weapons or ammo, and he kept complaining about, like, how, you know, how could the game throw all the shit at him with no ammo? And I'm like, dude, you're supposed to have ammo here. You're supposed to have all of the ammo that you collected in the previous levels. You know, you're doing this to yourself. I don't know. I don't get it. Why deliberately make the game harder for yourself and then complain about it? Which, I mean, okay. That's what I'm doing by not save scumming. And I get that. It's a similar mindset, I guess. You know. I do want to make the game more challenging for myself. More challenging than just safe scumming my way through it would be, which is why if I do save, I will end up using that auto-save mod. But, like, where I got crushed just now, it wouldn't have been an issue if I had been safe scumming, so I shouldn't complain about it, right? But that's just a poorly designed element of the level. Like, they're punishing me for not safe scumming, which, to me, that's different than punishing you for not having weapons and ammo. Like, the player should be reasonably expected to have some weapons and ammo. And they give you stuff, you know, just in case, but, you know, it's just barely enough. Because, ideally, you should have been what I've been doing, and, you know, looking for secrets, hunting down, you know, extra weapons and ammo so that you have it for the later levels. And if you're not doing that, then yeah, I think it makes sense to punish the player a little bit for that. But, in my opinion, safe scumming shouldn't be part of the design. And, you know, this game came out in 1983, so I have to cut it some slack. There wasn't a lot of good ideas about save systems at that point. Wow. That imp followed me all the way out here, huh? But still, like, surprise being crushed to death and just having to start over, that's never a good design element. Oh, this thing. Oh, no, it does. Okay. I was like, this thing doesn't even show up as a door. But, it was just small and hard to see until I zoomed in. All right, when I went into the crusher room, I actually thought I was going back. Because I didn't need to go in the crusher room at that point. I found the arrow. I was just going to go back and kill the Keymaster. So this time I'll be more careful. Yeah, there are a lot of things about the original Doom that didn't age well, and that's why I use mods as heavily as I do to, introduce some quality of life features that weren't there in the original, that I think the game is better for it. But, I don't know, starting with just a pistol just seems so unnecessarily masochistic, but I don't know. I guess ultimately the person was enjoying it, otherwise he wouldn't do that. Okay, so I guess stuff was re-randomized. Oh god. I thought I was in a different room. That's weird. What's with that texture? That's weird. It's like I'm seeing visions of hell. I cannot believe I just did that. Excuse me. Coming through. You know what? I'm going to cut the video here and give this another try a little bit later. I'm not on tilt. This isn't a rage quit. It's just the length of the video and the song ending is making me think that I should split it here. So I will see you soon. Goodbye.